we walk in the spirit. We can tell the man is on time.
Am
I talking right here? So Jesus, we've seen this dispensation. I am relevant. Do I talk to people right here? When you are walking in the spirit, there are two ways that will come to you. Number one is the word commitment. Number two is the word focus. So if you are committed, don't lose focus. Keep on going, because you are within time and season. There was a time when Shaka Zulu was brought on the throne to take over from his father. Shaka Zulu said, before I take over, I want to go to my uncle, Dingiswayo. He said to his uncle and all the men, before I take over, I want all the people who were born before me to be all killed. Dingiswayo said, why are you killing them? He said, these people, they will never believe in me because they saw me when I had nothing. They saw me when I was barefooted. It will be impossible for them to believe in me. But I want my generation, before I sit on the throne, kill all men who came before me. That was Shaka Zulu. What are you saying, prophet? I'm saying to you, the reason why people don't believe in you, those are not your generation. Those are not your people. Don't waste your time. Walk away. Be committed in your vision. Focus. Eyes on the ball.
Before I came here this year, 2 months back, I had a vision whereby prophet was anointing me on the left side hand. So I decided to come to this church. That day, prophet gave me a prophecy. He called me, he said, I see a pain on your ear. Then he started praying for me. While he was praying for me, he said, wow, what a healing anointing. I knew exactly what he was talking about. I received. The following week, he called me. He said, whatever that is in me is in you. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to impart you. He prayed for me. He imparted me. People of God, I had a brother who was very sick. He was at Radicelli. I didn't want to go to pray for him, but God instructed me to go and pray for my brother. As I'm talking right now, he went back. He's healed. He went back to work. Hallelujah. There are so many people that have been calling me. I have been praying for them through the phone. Some were hospitalized. I am talking about the people who are discharged right now.
Favor is coming. Favor is coming. It's like I'm prophesying the second time, isn't it?
Come on. The second time, and the lady that you have just prayed for, we came together.
You came together.
I went to fetch her in the
morning. You went to fetch her?
Yes.
What's her name?
Her name is Banyana.
Banyana.
Yes.
You went to fetch her?
Yes.
After your prophecy that came here?
When I came here before, you prophesied about Mpo.
Yes.
I said Mpo is my cousin.
Yes.
So I brought Mpo's mother too.
Okay.
He's also here.
She's
also
here.
Yes.
Okay. I hear Mpo. The same time,
and I'm
the
cousin of mine.
It is your cousin of yours, or your mother's. Okay, hallelujah. Been going through also some stagnations,
right.
But the Lord is going to help. In the next service, please tell them that I want to see them there right now.
I want to see them right here.
To come. Because I'm going to break the chains.
Last week or 2 weeks back, you said you see Mpo and Mpo is in stagnation and everything. How are we related? I said, Mpo is my cousin.
It's your cousin.
So I told the mother.
Okay.
So she came here to represent him.
Wow. Mama, when I learn Tomo and I'm also been Sahamona. Who would get the Mosu Ben Sahamona? Mona. Who would Kokumona? Amen. Would you more for this? Hallelujah. And would you want to go to the house?
I release that over your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And God is touching your knees also. And Mpo is going to be free. It's going to be free in the name of Jesus.